What's up guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm gonna give you my best Adobe Illustrator tips on how to convert your mood board from a bunch of pictures like this to something creative like this. Here's another example. We go from this to this. Okay, let's do one more. This to this. Okay, enough with the examples. Let's get started with the tips. So the very first thing I want to teach you is how to get an effect like this, where a picture is cropped along its boundary and placed on the mood board. Now this is done through a simple feature called clip masking. And here is how. This is what the original photo looked like, and in order to crop it along its boundaries, I'm gonna first select my pen tool and making sure that it has a stroke in any bright color. I'm gonna simply draw a shape along the boundaries of the picture like so. Now I'm going to click on both the boundary shape I drew and the picture underneath it. Right click and choose Make Clipping Mask. And just like that, the picture has been cropped along the boundary that we drew. You can now go place it on your mood board. The second effect that I want to show you is adding a white border to a clip masked image like you can see here. So start by performing the clip mask effect along the boundary like I showed you in tip 1. And once that is done, select your group selection tool and with it, click anywhere on the boundary of this image. Now create a copy using the shortcuts Command C and Command Shift V. The copy has appeared, but it cannot be seen because it has no fill and no stroke. So while it is still highlighted, come up here and change the stroke to a white color and also increase the stroke width to about 6. Now right-click the white line, go to Arrange, Send to Back, and you are done. Your white outline is now ready. The third effect is adding a shadow to images. For example, the same image that we just gave a white border to is standing out a bit more on this mood board, and that is because behind it is a shadow. Now I would use this shadow effect on the most important pictures on my mood board so that it straight up catches the attention of the viewer at first glance. And doing the effect again is very simple, guys. Back on the picture that we were working on, before we begin with the shadow effect, make sure that both the outline and the picture are grouped together. For this, highlight both the picture and the white border at the back, right click and choose Group. Now let's go give this whole thing a shadow. So come up here to Effect, Stylize, and Drop Shadow. The shadow has now been applied, and along with it, this box of settings also opens up. Make sure that Preview is ticked so that you can see the shadow while you adjust your settings. You can leave the settings as is, or you can do some cool things like reduce the blur of the shadow, which basically reduces how much your shadow spreads out. You can also increase the X offset and the shadow will extend along the X axis. You can reduce the opacity and so on. Hit OK when you are done and your shadow is also done. Now the fourth effect is the tone paper effect like you can see here. Here's what you need to do. First, select your pencil tool, but before we draw anything, double click on the pencil tool icon to check its settings. Make sure that fidelity is set to accurate and then hit OK. Now give it a red stroke and roughly draw a shape like so in one go. When this much is drawn for just two sides of the picture, I'm going to switch tools and go to my pen tool. So hit P to bring up the pen tool, or you can select it from here and connect your pen tool to the last point that you stopped your pencil at and continue closing the shape. And we are done. Next, we are going to select something called the wrinkle tool. And here is where you find it, guys. Now with the wrinkle tool, I'm going to simply click on various areas of my red border drawn. And as you can see, the lines are wrinkling up and getting all messy. When you are done, it will look something like this. Now, click the line and make a copy that will fall exactly behind the original. The shortcuts to do this is Command C and Command B. But first, just hit Command C, and before you hit Command B, highlight both the red border drawn and the picture behind it and clip mask it. Now hit Command B and the red border copy has gone to the very back. So while it is still highlighted at the back, remove the red stroke and add a white fill instead. Now use the arrow keys on your keyboard to hit the up arrow once and the right arrow key once. And your tone paper effect is now done. For the fifth effect, I'm going to show you how to completely redo the graphic on a garment. Now, very often, guys, you will come across the picture of a garment that has the perfect color and fabric and silhouette, etc. for your mood board. But the graphic will be so wrong and out of context. For example, in my mood board, this image never looked like this. It looked like this when I first picked it up. So what I would do in such a situation is to edit the picture into having a graphic that is more apt for my theme and basically force it to fit into my mood board. Now for this effect, you will need to have Photoshop as well installed on your laptop. So what I did to modify this graphic was to start by highlighting my image, then coming up here to unembed. Now, unembedding an image basically means that that image will no longer be stored on Adobe Illustrator. Instead, it will open up this box asking you to save or store the image on your desktop instead. Don't worry about the file name, you will mostly have a random slew of alphabets as well, but I'm gonna next hit save. Now select the Edit in Photoshop option and the image will then open up in Photoshop for you. So now that we are in Photoshop, let's zoom in and I'll show you how to delete the artworks one by one. I'm going to start by choosing the Spot Healing Brush tool, which removes unwanted spots and marks and objects in your picture. And I'm using it to draw over a small artwork that I want removed, like so. And as you can see, the artwork has completely disappeared. Let's try it again on a different artwork. And this disappears as well. So in this way, I'm going to keep removing artworks one by one. Sometimes you might have to use this tool 2 to 3 times over a specific spot to get it perfectly cleared. Now another way to remove artworks is the Clone Stamp tool. Now this tool copies pixels from one area and pastes them in another area. So to copy an area, hold down Option on your keyboard and simply click. Now wherever you want to clone the area that you just copied, go click again. Also, feel free to adjust the flow and the opacity up here. This will ensure that the area that you copy and paste will be more in quantity and more opaque, respectively. Keep going with these two tools, guys, and in this manner, the entire top slowly gets cleared. And finally, we are left with this. Now, what you need to do is save your file, and when you go back to Illustrator, this message will pop up asking you if you would like to update your file to the latest edit that you made. Let me bring this down to the side so that you can see the updating that happens now. So when I hit yes, the image updates itself to our latest edited image. Now remember to embed the file once again so that it gets stored back in Illustrator. Next, I'm going to place an artwork of my liking that resonates with my theme onto this top. And that is how this image was put into my mood board. Now the sixth effect is very similar to the fifth, except we are looking at color modification instead of graphic modification. Now what happens if you find a picture of a garment with the perfect graphics and silhouettes and fabrics, etc., but the colors are totally off? Let's say that I want to add this picture to this mood board and the graphic and silhouette, etc. is perfect, but clearly the colors of the dress are all wrong. As you can see here, this is the color palette that I need, which I got from my mood board. So once again, let's go edit the colors in Photoshop. Like we did in tip number 5, we unembed the image, save it, and then select Edit in Photoshop. Now Photoshop is so much fun, guys. It allows you to select just a small area of your image and change the color. Let's say that I want to change this pink coconut tree into an orange one, matching the color on my mood board's color palette like you can see here. In order to change the color, we first need to select the area of the coconut tree. Now there are a few ways that you can select the area, but I'm going to start by first showing you the magnetic lasso tool. Select it from here and simply click once anywhere on the boundary of the tree and freely move your mouse like so without clicking again. And you'll see that the lines created by this tool automatically stick like a magnet to the boundary of the tree. You only need to click a second time in order to close the selected area when you are back at the point where you started. And your selection is ready. Now these three tools up here are important now that you have made your selection. If you would like to add more to your existing selection, click on this button and continue drawing to add more shapes. If you would like to minus anything from your existing selection, click this button and anything you draw now will cut out or delete areas from your selection. And finally, if you want to totally disregard your existing selection and start a new selection from scratch, click here and start drawing. This one is barely used, so I'm going to skip that. So So I personally am all right with my current selection, so I'm not going to use these tools for now. So to change the color of the tree, come here to Image, Adjustments, and choose Hue Saturation. And when the table opens up, I'm going to start with Hue and adjust it like this. And you can see that the pink shade has totally changed into an orange one. I'm also going to increase the saturation of the color here so that it looks more orange. And I'm going to reduce the lightness. And with just this much, you can see that the orange is right now very easily matching the orange on my Moodboards color palette. So in this way, guys, I'm going to change more colors on this dress. Before you select the next area for color modification, like I showed you some time ago, come up here and click the new selection icon. Then let's highlight this area, open up Hue Saturation, make adjustments, and just like that, one more color is matching on our Moodboards color palette. Now, sometimes using the magnetic lasso tool will not be the best option because it might not give you the most accurate selection. In which case, what you can do is come here and pick the polygonal lasso tool instead. To make a selection with this tool, you click once, then click again, and you keep clicking to make your selection complete. Now, as usual, go adjust the hue and saturation. So in this way, guys, I kept modifying my colors and I ended up with something looking like this, perfectly matching my Moodboards color palette. Like before, when you are done, save your file. And then when you go back to Illustrator, you will get a pop-up like this. I'm going to move this to the corner and hit OK. And as you can see, the file has updated its colors. It can now very easily fit into my Moodboard. Now guys, remember that this color modification tip can be used in so many other ways. You can change the color of backgrounds, certain parts of a graphic. You can change hair color, accessory colors, and so much more using the very same techniques. Okay, now for my seventh tip, I'm going to show you guys how to remove backgrounds. Now remember my first tip? We used clip masks to crop out an item, thereby in the process getting rid of the background. But what if you have a complicated image like this? Let's say that I want to place it here on my mood board, behind this Polaroid photo. The white background is obviously in the way and it's far too time consuming to create a clip mask around every leaf and stalk in order to crop it out. So the quicker thing to do is to open this image in Photoshop and simply delete the background. Let me show you how. Like always, unembed your image and select Edit in Photoshop. Now in Photoshop, we need to first select all the white background area before we delete it. And in order to make a selection, I previously showed you the magnetic lasso tool and the polygonal lasso tool in tip number 6. But using those tools here again will be far too time consuming. So instead, I'm going to choose the magic wand tool. Now with this tool, I'm going to click on the white background like so. And as you can see, most of it has got selected. But there are a few white areas here that have not been selected. But instead of individually clicking those areas again with my magic wand tool, I'm going to come here to select and similar. And now all the similar white areas on this picture have been selected. Then I'm going to choose the background eraser tool and with it simply draw like so. And you can see that it created this sort of checkered area, which basically depicts the area where my white background has been erased. Now simply hit delete and the entire white background will disappear. Then like always guys, hit save. And when you get back to Illustrator, hit yes when this pops up. And your image has now updated itself, minusing the white background completely. How cool was that? You guys can see all these tiny leaves bordering my mood board, right? Like here and here and here. Yeah, all these were done in the same way. Okay, for my 8th effect, we're going to look at transparency and blend mode options within Adobe Illustrator itself. Now, what do I mean by that? If you bring in a picture of any mood-related element, particularly one that is on a white background, then you can add some serious creativity and dimension to your board by messing with the blending mode. For example, to my board, let's say I want to add some black dots over my pictures. I'm going to paste an image like this. Then open up my transparency panel and change the blending mode to darken. Now only the black dots remain, adding a pretty cool effect to my mood board. Similarly, you can add smoke and this is what it will look like. Or you can add strokes of paint In the same way, guys, there are so many things that you can add. For example, bits of stationery like paper clips, duct tape, board pins, etc. You can add pieces of cloth, pieces of paper. The same goes for text. Let's say that I have a concept note or a simple sentence that I want to add to my board. I'm going to first type out a sentence like this, then place it where it could look nice on my board. But if you see here, the text is black and therefore dissolves into certain darker areas on the board, making it illegible. In this case, a blending mode that I like to use is Color Dodge. And this gives my text a pretty cool multi-shade sort of effect. So definitely try out all the blending modes here. A lot of the tinier elements you see on this board actually came together through my varied experiments with blending modes. And for my 9th and final tip, I just want to say, go crazy. Invert some of the pictures on your mood boards or flip them horizontally. Put strange pictures in the oddest of places. I put a CD on her head, guys. I mean, that might be a bit extreme, right? If you have empty spaces, fill them with trims like buttons or zippers. If you have a darker emotional theme, you can add burnt things. Like this board, for example, has multiple references to burnt paper and ash. Add grunginess through a lot of black spots and texture that looks like dust. Try to bring in as many mood-relevant images as you can. So that's it for my mood board creating tips, guys. Now go make some amazing mood boards and I will see you next week.